चैप्टर 4 एनिमल किंगडम। व्हेन यू लुक अराउंड यू विल ऑब्जर्व डिफरेंट एनिमल्स विद डिफरेंट स्ट्रक्चर्स एंड फॉर्म्स। एज ओवर अ मिलियन स्पीशीज ऑफ एनिमल्स हैव बीन डिस्क्राइब्ड टिल नाउ, द नीड फॉर क्लासिफिकेशन बिकम्स ऑल द मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट। द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑल्सो हेल्प इन असाइनिंग अ सिस्टमेटिक पोजिशन टू न्यूली डिस्क्राइब्ड स्पीशीज। 4.1 बेसिस ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन। In spite of differences in structure and form of different animals, there are fundamental features common to various individuals in relation to the arrangement of cells, body symmetry, nature of coelom, patterns of digestive, circulatory or reproductive systems. These features are used as the basis of animal classification and some of them are discussed here. 4.1.1 Levels of organization. Though all members of Animalia are multicellular, all of them do not exhibit the same pattern of organization of cells. For example, in sponges, the cells are arranged as loose cell aggregates, that is, they exhibit cellular level of organization. Some division of labor, that is, activities, occur among the cells. In coelenterates, the arrangement of cells is more complex. Here the cells performing the same function are arranged into tissues, hence is called tissue level of organization. A still higher level of organization, that is, organ level, is exhibited by members of platyhelminthes and other higher phyla, where tissues are grouped together to form organs, each specialized for a particular function. In animals like annelids, arthropods, mollusks, echinoderms and chordates, organs have associated to form functional systems, each system concerned with a specific physiological function. This pattern is called organ system level of organization. Organ systems in different groups of animals exhibit various patterns of complexities. For example, the digestive system in platyhelminthes has only a single opening to the outside of the body that serves as both mouth and anus, and is hence called incomplete. A complete digestive system has two openings, mouth and anus. Similarly, the circulatory system may be of two types. First, open type, in which the blood is pumped out of the heart and the cells and tissues are directly bathed in it. And second, closed type, in which the blood is circulated through a series of vessels of varying diameters, that is, arteries, veins and capillaries. 4.1.2 Symmetry. Animals can be categorized on the basis of their symmetry. Sponges are mostly asymmetrical, that is, any plane that passes through the center does not divide them into equal halves. When any plane passing through the central axis of the body divides the organism into two identical halves, it is called radial symmetry. Coelenterates, ctenophores, and echinoderms have this kind of body plan. Animals like annelids, arthropods, etc., where the body can be divided into identical left and right halves in only one plane, exhibit bilateral symmetry. 4.1.3 Diploblastic and triploblastic organization. Animals in which the cells are arranged in two embryonic layers, an external ectoderm and an internal endoderm, are called diploblastic animals. Example, coelenterates. An undifferentiated layer, mesoglia, is present in between the ectoderm and the endoderm. Those animals in which the developing embryo has a third germinal layer, mesoderm, in between the ectoderm and endoderm, are called triploblastic animals, that is, platyhelminthes, two chordates. 4.1.4 Coelom. Presence or absence of a cavity between the body wall and the gut wall is very important in classification. The body cavity, which is lined by mesoderm, is called coelom. Animals possessing coelom are called coelomates. Example, annelids, mollusks, arthropods, echinoderms, hemichordates, and chordates. In some animals, the body cavity is not lined by mesoderm. Instead, the mesoderm is present as scattered pouches in between the ectoderm and endoderm. Such a body cavity is called pseudocoelom, and the animals possessing them are called pseudocoelomates. Example, Aeshelminthes. The animals in which the body cavity is absent are called acoelomates. Example, platyhelminthes. 4.1.5 Segmentation. In some animals, the body is externally and internally divided into segments with a serial repetition of at least some organs. For example, in earthworm, the body shows this pattern called metameric segmentation, and the phenomena is known as metamerism. 4.1.6 नोटोकॉर्ड। नोटोकॉर्ड इज अ मेसोडर्मली डिराइव्ड रॉड लाइक स्ट्रक्चर फॉर्मड ऑन द डॉर्सल साइड ड्यूरिंग एम्ब्रियोनिक डेवलपमेंट इन सम एनिमल्स। एनिमल्स विथ नोटोकॉर्ड आर कॉल्ड कॉर्डेट्स एंड दोज एनिमल्स विच डू नॉट फॉर्म दिस स्ट्रक्चर आर कॉल्ड नॉन कॉर्डेट्स। एग्जाम्पल पॉरीफेरा टू इकाइनोडर्म्स। 4.2 क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एनिमल्स। द ब्रॉड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एनिमेलिया बेस्ड ऑन कॉमन फंडामेंटल फीचर्स एज मेंशन्ड इन द प्रोसीजिंग सेक्शन इज गिवन इन फिगर 4.4। द इम्पॉर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर्स ऑफ द डिफरेंट फाइला आर डिस्क्राइब्ड। 4.2.1 फाइलम पॉरीफेरा। मेंबर्स ऑफ दिस फाइलम आर कॉमनली नोन एज स्पंजेस। दे आर जनरली मरीन एंड मोस्टली एसिमेट्रिकल एनिमल्स। दीज आर प्रिमिटिव मल्टीसेलुलर एनिमल्स एंड हैव सेलुलर लेवल ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। स्पंजेस हैव अ वाटर ट्रांसपोर्ट और कैनाल सिस्टम। वाटर एंटर्स थ्रू माइन्यूट पोर्स दैट इज ओस्टिया इन द बॉडी वॉल इनटू अ सेंट्रल कैविटी स्पॉन्जोसील फ्रॉम वेयर इट गोज आउट थ्रू द ऑस्क्यूलम। दिस पाथवे ऑफ वाटर ट्रांसपोर्ट इज हेल्पफुल इन फूड गैदरिंग रेस्पिरेटरी एक्सचेंज एंड रिमूवल ऑफ वेस्ट। क्वेनोसाइट्स और कॉलर सेल्स लाइन द स्पॉन्जोसील एंड द कैनाल्स। डाइजेशन इज इंट्रासेल्युलर। द बॉडी इज सपोर्टेड बाई अ स्केलेटन मेड अप ऑफ स्पिक्यूल्स और स्पंजिन फाइबर्स। सेक्सेज आर नॉट सेपरेट दैट इज हर्माफ्रोडाइट दैट इज एग्स एंड स्पर्म्स आर प्रोड्यूस्ड बाई द सेम इंडिविजुअल। स्पंजेस रिप्रोड्यूस ए सेक्सुअली बाई फ्रेगमेंटेशन एंड सेक्सुअली बाई फॉर्मेशन ऑफ गैमेट्स। फर्टिलाइजेशन इज इंटरनल एंड डेवलपमेंट इज इनडायरेक्ट हैविंग अ लार्वल स्टेज विच इज मॉर्फोलॉजिकली डिस्टिंक्ट फ्रॉम द एडल्ट। एग्जाम्पल्स साइकन दैट इज स्काइफा स्पॉन्जिला दैट इज फ्रेश वाटर स्पॉन्ज एंड यू स्पॉन्जिया दैट इज बाथ स्पॉन्ज। 4.2.2 फाइलम सिलेंट्रेटा दैट इज निडेरिया। दे आर एक्वाटिक मोस्टली मरीन सीजाइल और फ्री स्विमिंग रेडियली सिमेट्रिकल एनिमल्स। द नेम निडेरिया इज डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम द नीडोब्लास्ट और नीडोसाइट्स दैट इज विच कंटेन द स्टिंगिंग कैप्स्यूल्स और नीमेटोसाइट्स प्रेजेंट ऑन द टेंटैकल्स एंड द बॉडी। Nidoblasts are used for anchorage, defense, and for the capture of prey. Nidarians exhibit tissue level of organization and are diploblastic. They have a central gastrovascular cavity with a single opening, mouth on hypostome. Digestion is extracellular and intracellular. Some of the Nidarians, example, corals have a skeleton composed of calcium carbonate. Nidarians exhibit two basic body forms called polyp and medusa. The former is a sigile and cylindrical form like hydra, adamsia, etc. Where is the latter is umbrella shaped and free swimming like Euralia or jellyfish. Those Nidarians which exist in both forms exhibit alternation of generation, that is metagenesis. That is, polyps produce medusa asexually and medusa form the polyps sexually. Example, Ovelia. Examples, Physalia, that is Portuguese man of war, Adamsia, that is sea anemone, Penatula, that is sea pen, Gorgonia, that is sea fan, and Mandrina, that is brain coral. 4.2.3 Phylum Tenophora. Tenophores, commonly known as sea walnuts or comb jellies, are exclusively marine, radially symmetrical, diploblastic organisms with tissue level of organization. The body bears eight external rows of ciliated comb plates, which help in locomotion. Digestion is both extracellular and intracellular. Bioluminescence, that is, the property of a living organism to emit light, is well marked in Tenophores. Sexes are not separate. Reproduction takes place only by sexual means. Fertilization is external with indirect development. Examples, Pleurobrachia and Tenoplana. 4.2.4 Phylum Platyhelminthes. They have dorsoventrally flattened body, hence are called flatworms. These are mostly endoparasites found in animals including human beings. Flatworms are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic and acoelomate animals with organ level of organization. Hooks and suckers are present in the parasitic forms. Some of them absorb nutrients from the host directly through their body surface. Specialized cells called flame cells help in osmoregulation and excretion. Sexes are not separate. Fertilization is internal and development is through many larval stages. Some members like Planaria possess high regeneration capacity. Examples, Tinea that is tapeworm, Fasciola that is liver fluke. 4.2.5 Phylum Aeshelminthes. The body of the Aeshelminthes is circular in cross section, hence the name roundworms. They may be free living, aquatic and terrestrial or parasitic in plants and animals. Roundworms have organ system level of body organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic and pseudocoelomate animals. Alimentary canal is complete with a well-developed muscular pharynx. An excretory tube removes body waste from the body cavity through the excretory pore. Sexes are separate, that is dioecious. That is, males and females are distinct. Often females are longer than males. Fertilization is internal and development may be direct, that is, the young ones resemble the adult, or indirect. Examples: Ascaris, that is roundworm, Wuchereria, that is filaria worm, Ankylostoma, that is hookworm. 4.2.6 Phylum Annelida. They may be aquatic, that is marine and freshwater, or terrestrial, free living and sometimes parasitic. They exhibit organ system level of body organization and bilateral symmetry. They are triploblastic, metamerically segmented and coelomate animals. Their body surface is distinctly marked out into segments or metameres, and hence the phylum name Annelida, that is Latin annulus, means little ring. They possess longitudinal and circular muscles which help in locomotion. Aquatic annelids like Nereis possess later appendages, parapodia, which help in swimming. A closed circulatory system is present. Nephridia help in osmoregulation and excretion. Neural system consists of paired ganglia connected by lateral nerves to a double ventral nerve cord. Nereis, an aquatic form, is dioecious, but earthworms and leeches are monoecious. Reproduction is sexual. Examples: Nereis ferratina, that is earthworm, and Hirudinaria, that is blood-sucking leech. 4.2.7 Phylum Arthropoda. This is the largest phylum of Animalia, which includes insects. Over 2/3 of all named species on Earth are arthropods. They have organ system level of organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, segmented and coelomate animals. The body of arthropods is covered by chitinous exoskeleton. The body consists of head, thorax and abdomen. They have jointed appendages, that is arthrod joint poda appendages. Respiratory organs are gills, book lungs or tracheal system. Circulatory system is of open type. Sensory organs like antenna, eyes, that is compound and simple, stetocyst or balancing organs are present. Excretion takes place through Malpighian tubules. They are mostly dioecious. Fertilization is usually internal. They are mostly oviparous. Development may be direct or indirect. Examples: economically important insects, Apis, that is honeybee, Bombyx, that is silkworm, Lysipher, that is like insect. Vectors: Anopheles, Culex and Aedes, that is mosquitoes. Gregarious pest, Locusta, that is locust. Living fossil, Limulus, that is king crab. 4.2.8 Phylum Mollusk. This is the second largest animal phylum. Mollusks are terrestrial or aquatic, that is marine or freshwater, having an organ system level of organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic and coelomate animals. Body is covered by a calcareous shell and is unsegmented with a distinct head, muscular foot and visceral hump. A soft and spongy layer of skin forms a mantle over the visceral hump. The space between the hump and the mantle is called the mantle cavity, in which feather-like gills are present. They have respiratory and excretory functions. The anterior head region has sensory tentacles. The mouth contains a file-like rasping organ for feeding, called radula. They are usually dioecious and oviparous with indirect development. Examples: Pila, that is apple snail, Pinctada, that is pearl oyster, Sepia, that is cuttlefish, Loligo, that is squid, Octopus, that is devilfish, Aplysia, that is sea hare, Dentalium, that is tusk shell, and Ketopleura, that is chitin. 4.2.9 Phylum Echinodermata. These animals have an endoskeleton of calcareous ossicles and hence the name Echinodermata, that is spiny-bodied. All are marine with organ system level of organization. The adult echinoderms are radially symmetrical, but larvae are bilaterally symmetrical. They are triploblastic and coelomate animals. Digestive system is complete with mouth on the lower, that is ventral side, and anus on the upper, that is dorsal side. The most distinctive feature of echinoderms is the presence of water vascular system, which helps in locomotion, capture and transport of food and respiration. An excretory system is absent. Sexes are separate. Reproduction is sexual. Fertilization is usually external. Development is indirect with pre-swimming larva. Examples: Asterius, that is starfish, Echinus, that is sea urchin, Antedon, that is sea lily, Cucumeria, that is sea cucumber, and Ophura, that is brittle star. 4.2.10 Phylum Hemichordata. Hemichordata was earlier considered as a subphylum under phylum Chordata, but now it is placed as a separate phylum under non-chordata. Hemichordates have a rudimentary structure in the collar region called stomochord, a structure similar to notochord. This phylum consists of a small group of worm-like marine animals with organ system level of organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic and coelomate animals. The body is cylindrical and is composed of an anterior proboscis, a collar and a long trunk. Circulatory system is of open type. Respiration takes place through gills. Excretory organ is proboscis gland. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is external. Development is indirect. Examples: Balanoglossus and Psychoglossus. 4.2.11 Phylum Chordata. Animals belonging to phylum Chordata are fundamentally characterized by the presence of a notochord, a dorsal hollow nerve cord, and paired pharyngeal gill slits. These are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, coelomate with organ system level of organization. They possess a postcranial tail and a closed circulatory system. Table 4.1. Presence or comparison of salient features of chordates and non-chordates. In the case of chordates, notochord present, and in the case of non-chordates, notochord absent. In the case of chordates, central nervous system is dorsal, hollow and single. And in the case of non-chordates, central nervous system is ventral, solid and double. In the case of chordates, pharynx perforated by gill slits. And in the case of non-chordates, gill slits are absent. In the case of chordates, heart is ventral. And in the case of non-chordates, heart is dorsal if present. In the case of chordates, a postcranial part, that is tail, is present. In the case of non-chordates, postcranial tail is absent. Phylum Chordata is divided into three subphyla: Urochordata or Tunicata, Cephalochordata and Vertebrata. Subphyla Urochordata and Cephalochordata are often referred to as protochordates and are exclusively marine. In Urochordata, notochord is present only in larval tail, while in Cephalochordata, it extends from head to tail region and is persistent throughout their life. Examples: Urochordata, Acidia salpa, Dolulum. Cephalochordata, Branchiostoma, that is Amphioxus or Lancelet. The members of subphylum Vertebrata possess notochord during the embryonic period. The notochord is replaced by a cartilaginous or bony vertebral column in the adult. Thus, all vertebrates are chordates, but all chordates are not vertebrates. Besides the basic chordate characters, vertebrates have a ventral muscular heart with 2, 3, or 4 chambers, kidneys for excretion and osmoregulation, and paired appendages which may be fins or limbs. 4.2.11.1 Class Cyclostomata. All living members of the class Cyclostomata are ectoparasites on some fishes. They have an elongated body bearing 6 to 15 pairs of gill slits for respiration. Cyclostomes have a sucking and circular mouth without jaws. Their body is devoid of scales and paired fins. Cranium and vertebral column are cartilaginous. Circulation is of closed type. Cyclostomes are marine but migrate for spawning to fresh water. After spawning, within a few days, they die. Their larvae, after metamorphosis, return to the ocean. Examples: Petromygon, that is lamprey, and Myxene, that is hagfish. 4.2.11.2 Class Chondrichthyes. They are marine animals with streamlined body and have cartilaginous endoskeleton. Mouth is located ventrally. Notochord is persistent throughout life. Gill slits are separate and without operculum, that is gill cover. The skin is tough, containing minute placoid scales. Teeth are modified placoid scales, which are bicoidally directed. Their jaws are very powerful. These animals are predaceous. Due to the absence of air bladder, they have to swim constantly to avoid sinking. Heart is two-chambered, that is one auricle and one ventricle. Some of them have electric organs, example torpedo, and some possess poison sting, example trigon. They are cold-blooded, that is poikilothermous animals, that is they lack the capacity to regulate their body temperature. Sexes are separate. In males, pelvic fins bear claspers. They have internal fertilization and many of them are viviparous. Examples, scolodon, that is dogfish, pristis, that is swordfish, carcharodon, that is great white shark, trigon, that is stingray. 4.2.11.3 Class Osteichthyes. It includes both marine and freshwater fishes with bony endoskeleton. Their body is streamlined, mouth is mostly terminal. They have four pairs of gills which are covered by an operculum on each side. Skin is covered with cycloid or tenoid scales. Air bladder is present which regulates buoyancy. Heart is two-chambered, that is one auricle and one ventricle. They are cold-blooded animals. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is usually external. They are mostly oviparous and development is direct. Examples, marine ixocoitus, that is flying fish, hippocampus, that is seahorse, freshwater, labio, that is rohu, katla, clarius, that is magur, aquarium, beta, that is fighting fish, pterophyllum, that is angelfish. 4.2.11.4 Class Amphibia. As the name indicates, amphi means dual, bios means life. Amphibians can live in aquatic as well as terrestrial habitats. Most of them have two pairs of limbs. Body is divisible into head and trunk. Tail may be present in some. The amphibian skin is moist, that is without scales. The eyes have eyelids. A tympanum represents the ear. Alimentary canal, urinary and reproductive tracts open into a common chamber called cloaca, which opens to the exterior. Respiration is by gills, lungs and through skin. The heart is three-chambered, that is two auricles and one ventricle. These are cold-blooded animals. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is external. They are oviparous and development is indirect. Examples, bufo, that is toad, rana, that is frog, hyla, that is tree frog, salamandra, that is salamander, ichthyophis, that is limbless amphibia. 4.2.11.5 Class Reptilia. The class name refers to their creeping or crawling mode of locomotion, that is Latin repair or reptum, to creep or crawl. They are mostly terrestrial animals and their body is covered by dry and cornified skin, epidermal scales or scutes. They do not have external ear openings. Tympanum represents ear. Limbs, when present, are two pairs. Heart is usually three-chambered, but four-chambered in crocodiles. Reptiles are poikilotherms. Snakes and lizards share their scales as skin cast. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is internal. They are oviparous and development is direct. Examples, chelon, that is turtle, testudo, that is tortoise, chameleon, that is tree lizard, calotus, that is garden lizard, crocodilus, that is crocodile, alligator, that is alligator, hemidactylus, that is wall lizard, poisonous snakes, naja, that is cobra, bangaras, that is creed, vipera, that is viper. 4.2.11.6 Class Apes. The characteristic feature of apes, that is birds, are the presence of feathers and most of them can fly except flightless birds, example ostrich. They possess beak. The forelimbs are modified into wings. The hind limbs generally have scales and are modified for walking, swimming or clasping the tree branches. Skin is dry without glands except the oil gland at the base of the tail. Endoskeleton is fully ossified, that is bony, and the long bones are hollow with air cavities, that is pneumatic. The digestive tract of birds has additional chambers, the crop and gizzard. Heart is completely four-chambered. They are warm-blooded, that is homeothermous animals. That is, they are able to maintain a constant body temperature. Respiration is by lungs. Air sacs connected to lungs supplement respiration. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is internal. They are oviparous and development is direct. Examples: corvus, that is crow; columba, that is pigeon; sitacula, that is parrot; struthio, that is ostrich; pavo, that is peacock; itinodytus, that is penguin; neophron, that is vulture. 4.2.11.7 Class: mammalia. They are found in a variety of habitats: polar ice caps, deserts, mountains, forest, grassland, and dark caves. Some of them have adapted to fly or live in water. The most unique mammalian characteristic is the presence of milk-producing glands, that is mammary glands, by which the young ones are nourished. They have two pairs of limbs adapted for walking, running, climbing, burrowing, swimming, or flying. The skin of mammals is unique in possessing hair. External ears or pinna are present. Different types of teeth are present in the jaw. Heart is four-chambered. They are homeothermous. Respiration is by lungs. Sexes are separate and fertilization is internal. They are viviparous with few exceptions and development is direct. Examples: oviparous, ornithorhynchus, that is platypus; viviparous, macropus, that is kangaroo; pteropus, that is flying fox; camelus, that is camel; macaca, that is monkey; rattus, that is rat; canis, that is dog; felis, that is cat; eliphas, that is elephant; equus, that is horse; delphinus, that is common dolphin; balaenoptera, that is blue whale; panthera tigris, that is tiger; panthera leo, that is lion. The salient distinguishing features of all phyla under animal kingdom is comprehensively given in the table 4.2. Table 4.2: salient features of different phyla in the animal kingdom. Phylum Porifera. Level of organization: cellular. Symmetry: various. Coelom: absent. Segmentation: absent. Digestive system: absent. Circulatory system: absent. Respiratory system: absent. Distinctive features: body with pores and canals in walls. Phylum Cnidaria, that is Cnidaria. Levels of organization: tissue, symmetry, radial, coelom: absent. Segmentation: absent. Digestive system: incomplete. Circulatory system: absent. Respiratory system: absent. Distinctive features: nidoblast present. Phylum Ctenophora. Level of organization: tissue, symmetry, radial, coelom: absent. Segmentation: absent. Digestive system: incomplete. Circulatory system: absent. Respiratory system: absent. Distinctive features: comb plates for locomotion. Phylum Platyhelminthes. Levels of organization: organ and organ system. Symmetry: bilateral. Coelom: absent. Segmentation: absent. Digestive system: incomplete. Circulatory system: absent. Respiratory system: absent. Distinctive features: flat body, suckers. Phylum Aeshelminthes. Level of organization: organ system. Symmetry: bilateral. Coelom: pseudocoelomate. Segmentation: absent. Digestive system: complete. Circulatory system: absent. Respiratory system: absent. Distinctive feature: often worm-shaped, elongated. Phylum Annelida. Levels of organization: organ system. Symmetry: bilateral. Coelom: coelomate. Segmentation: present. Digestive system: complete. Circulatory system: present. Respiratory system: absent. Distinctive feature: body segmentation like rings. Phylum Arthropoda. Level of organization: organ system. Symmetry: bilateral. Coelom: coelomate. Segmentation: present. Digestive system: complete. Circulatory system: present. Respiratory system: present. Distinctive features: exoskeleton of cuticle, jointed appendages. Phylum Mollusca. Level of organization: organ system. Symmetry: bilateral. Coelom: coelomate. Segmentation: absent. Digestive system: complete. Circulatory system: present. Respiratory system: present. Distinctive features: external skeleton of shell usually present. Phylum Echinodermata. Level of organization: organ system. Symmetry: radial. Coelom: coelomate. Segmentation: absent. Digestive system: complete. सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम प्रेजेंट, रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम प्रेजेंट, डिस्टिंक्टिव फीचर वाटर वास्कुलर सिस्टम, रेडियल सिमेट्री। फाइलम हेमिकॉर्डेटा, लेवल ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, ऑर्गन सिस्टम सिमेट्री, बायलेटरल सिलोम सिलोमेट, सेगमेंटेशन अब्जेंट, डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम कंप्लीट, सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम प्रेजेंट, रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम प्रेजेंट, डिस्टिंक्टिव फीचर्स वर्म लाइक विथ प्रोबोसिस कॉलर एंड ट्रंक। फाइलम कॉर्डेटा, लेवल ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑर्गन सिस्टम सिमेट्री, बायलेटरल सिलोम सिलोमेट, सेगमेंटेशन प्रेजेंट, डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम कंप्लीट, सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम प्रेजेंट, रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम प्रेजेंट, डिस्टिंक्टिव फीचर्स नोटोकॉर्ड, डॉर्सल हॉलो नर्व कॉर्ड, गिल स्लिट्स विथ लिम्स और फिन्स। समरी, द बेसिक फंडामेंटल फीचर्स सच एज लेवल ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सिमेट्री, सेल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सिलोम सेगमेंटेशन नोटोकॉर्ड एट्सेट्रा हैव इनेबल्ड अस टू ब्रॉडली क्लासीफाई द एनिमल किंगडम। Besides the fundamental features, there are many other distinctive characters which are specific for each phyla or class. Porifera includes multicellular animals which exhibit cellular level of organization and have characteristic flagellated coenocytes. The coelenterates have tentacles and bear nidoblasts. They are mostly aquatic, sessile or free-floating. The tenophores are marine animals with comb plates. The platyhelminthes have flat body and exhibit bilateral symmetry. The parasitic forms show distinctive suckers and hooks. Aeshelminthes are pseudocoelomates and include parasitic as well as non-parasitic roundworms. Annelids are metamerically segmented animals with a true coelom. The arthropods are the most abundant group of animals characterized by the presence of jointed appendages. The mollusks have a soft body surrounded by an external calcareous shell. The body is covered with external skeleton made of chitin. The echinoderms possess a spiny skin. Their most distinctive feature is the presence of water vascular system. The hemichordates are a small group of worm-like marine animals. They have a cylindrical body with proboscis, collar and trunk. Phylum Chordata includes animals which possess a notochord either throughout or during early embryonic life. Other common features observed in chordates are the dorsal hollow nerve cord and paired pharyngeal gill slits. Some of the vertebrates do not possess jaws, that is agnatha, whereas most of them possess jaws, that is gnathostomata. Agnatha is represented by the class Cyclostomata. They are the most primitive chordates and are ectoparasites on some fishes. Gnathostomata has two superclasses, Pisces and Tetrapoda. Classes Chondrichthyes and Osteichthyes bear fins for locomotion and are grouped under Pisces. The Chondrichthyes are fishes with cartilaginous endoskeleton and are marine. Classes Amphibia, Reptilia, Apes and Mammalia have two pairs of limbs and are thus grouped under Tetrapoda. The amphibians have adopted to live both on land and water. Reptiles are characterized by the presence of dry and conified skin. Limbs are absent in snakes. Fishes, amphibians and reptiles are poikilothermous, that is cold-blooded. Apes are warm-blooded animals with feathers on their bodies and forelimbs modified into wings for flying. Hind limbs are adopted for walking, swimming, perching or clasping. The unique features of mammals are the presence of mammary glands and hairs on the skin. They commonly exhibit viviparity.